Shh!
It's Daddy Nien! Who's that?
Shh! You'll see.
It's the stoat he's gonna get Liam.
Just watch.
Snap there, you already know what happened.
I only know because my grandfather told me when I was sick.
It seems William is enjoying your play, Father. I'm happy he's found something to get his mind off everything else. William has grown into a fine young mouse.
He's taken quite a liking to the young scouts. You know, he told me that Sophia reminds him of a certain someone.
A certain someone? Who?
Why, you, of course.
Oh, goodness. I am nothing like Sophia. There are so many ways that I have failed him as a parent. I mean, his father...
William is a wise dibbon and an understanding one. He'll be all right.
Sorry.
Where have you been, Matthew? You missed the whole second act.
So sorry. I think I got that cold you had, William. I barely convinced Mum to let me come back and see the rest of the play.
Come on, you just made it in time for Act 3.
What's going on?
Liam is going to get eaten by stoats.
What I miss?
Shh, you guys, I want to watch.
Well, we've got to get Matthew up to speed. Liam made it to the lighthouse, but with Scumsnout hot on his heels...
Oh, wait. How did he get to the lighthouse again? And, why was Scumsnout there?
Scumsnout and his rats attacked Lilygrove. Remember? It was the night that Liam was awarded the title of Eagle Eye and initiated into the Lilygrove Scout Corps. But Scumsnout and his sea rats attacked, and so Captain Robin sent Liam to light the Lilygrove Lighthouse.
Oh, right. I remember now.
But then Scumsnout sent him flying off the lighthouse tower with his massive tail.
But don't worry, Liam was okay.
He landed in a pile of hay. Sophia had been bitten by Scumsnout, whose drool was as poisonous as an adder.
Ew!
She needed a healer, so Robin sent Liam and Sophia to the Winsome Wraith, where an old friend of his would be able to help them. Of course, Liam had some trouble along the way to the Wraith, but Fraby and the more Glimber joined in to help. They made new enemies too, like the Sea Rat Captain, Cheesethief. Cheesethief was after the mice because he knew they had a special key, the Tanagram. Then, in Pontederia, Liam had to battle Scumsnout again.
What is that weird problem?
Scumsnout chased Liam over the docks and bridges of Pontederia. Finally, Liam jumped across and Scumsnout... Well, he didn't make it.
It's about time.
He fell down into a giant sinkhole. And they all found the Winsome Wraith. There was just one catch. The healer was a stoat.
A stoat? But aren't stoats dangerous?
I guess you'll have to find out.
And what makes you think we want to help you, little mouse?
Well, we...
Stand down, Bolo. Now, scout, you said. Robin sent you.
Yes, that's right. Please, it's my Sophia here. She's being poisoned. Captain Robin said you could help her.
Of course we can.
They're strangers.
That's enough. Both of you. The mouse does look in a bad way. You better come inside. Welcome to the Winsome Wraith. This is my son, Bolo. My daughter, Mila.
Hi.
You'll have to forgive us for frightening you. We have a standard protocol for strange visitors.
I wasn't being frightened or hurt.
No. What's happened to this young mouse?
She was bit by that wretched were-it scum snout.
The one with the infectious snout.
I see. Come, here's the infirmary. I'll see to Sophia immediately.
What are you doing here, rat? And explain if you would.
property on a friendly knock would have sufficed.
I don't give a mouse's whisker about your property, sympathizer. We're looking for some mice, and we have reason to believe they're hiding with you.
What do you call sympathizer, rat? Well, I'm all this set of pathetic mice. They came this way, of course, but I skinned them off. Can't imagine why they didn't want to stay. Now, I'll kindly ask you lot to clear out as well.
But you seem such great hosts.
Here, Mousy Mousy. Old Thornfist's got something for you. Come out and play, whoever you are. Knew there was something going on in
here. I'm gonna find you, little mouse. Where have you gone?
Which way is Redwall?
I can barely see where we are.
Redwall, mean that way, Miss Sophie.
Right through the slough.
Portman Slough was a mysterious bog, rumored to have ensnared many wandering critters, woodlander and vermin alike in its time, none of whom were ever heard from again.
Careful, Sophia!
We's all gonna be drowning in this embalger.
Martin's whiskers! The stoats!
Sophia, wait! You can't just go dashing into a fire!
I did be seeing these stoaty babes lit out his ship before you did rescue me, Miss Sophie. I reckon they be out here somewhere with us.
So what about the tankrim? I left it with Valen.
I took it from his room, as soon as the rat showed.
Atessa, you're wonderful.
It was strange. I felt rather like something was calling me to fetch it.
I'm sure it was just your brilliant mind doing its good work, as usual. Now, how in Martin's name are we going to get through this?
But if I don't want to sink into the swamp, I just got to get...
clearly don't hear that.
Oh, we hear it all right. It's hissing like a maniac. We have to go back.
Look, everyone. It's just a snake skin.
I can't believe you almost drove us straight into a snake sphere.
Miss Sophie, how you been knowing it was safe?
A mouse. There was a mouse in the swamp. I heard his voice.
I say, there might not be a snake, young mouselings, but it belonged to one. And I don't recommend waiting for him to come find you.
Uncle Jeb!
Mila? What are you... Then, that fire... Never mind. All of you, come with me. We'd best make haste to safety. There's dangerous folk afoot tonight.
Wait, were you the one leading us out the slough all this time?
Certainly not. I just saw you now, emerging from the fog.
But if it wasn't you...
Soph, you don't think it was...
Come, good beast. Follow me.
His name was Captain Jeb Starthistle, and he was perhaps the most refined mouse Sophia had ever met, despite living in a swamp.
Is this your, house?
You'll stay with me for the night, of course. By then, Asmodeus should have had his fill and be settled down for a day of digestion. And I must say, it's rather cheery to have visitors. Mila, perhaps you can help me prepare. Mila, what have you got there, you rapscallion?
It's... I need it for studying.
My dear, please do not tell me you've gone and stolen another heart.
It's important, Uncle Jeb. It took me forever to get.
Very well, Mila, I won't take it from you, but you cannot keep it inside the house. Put it outside, under the porch.
Do she really be having a...
Maybe better not to ask, Glimber.
Now, on to Redwall, are you? Redwall may be northeast of here, but you'd do best to head due north through Grating Gully. On the other side, there's a secret route that will surely cut your travel time drastically.
A shortcut?
The old Otter's Den. It's a tunnel that cuts under the mountain. The only problem is that it requires a special key to open.
Wait, a special key? Freebie, you don't think he's referring to the Tangram?
I suspect it just might. Certainly worth a shot.
Well then, I suppose we're off to the Otter's Den.
So the noble scouts, with Captain Jeb's help, plotted their route to Redwall. But with the moon already high in the sky, it wasn't long before they were struggling to keep their eyes open.
You can't sleep, Mila?
No. I can still smell it in my nose.
Smell what?
The smoke. From our home.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Mila.
When we escaped, Bolo told me to flee into the bog. But I don't know what happened to him after I started running. And what about Papa? I should have called back for them.
Your Pa and Bolo are both strong, capable stoats. I'd bet a wheel of cheddar they're together right now, heading our way.
You think so?
I do. Now, you should be shutting your eyes. You don't want to be grumpy when you see them again in the morning.
Hello, my flower.
Valo, I'm so pleased to see you. Is everything all right?
Jeb, thank you for harboring my daughter and our friends last night. I'm afraid I must ask you to keep Mila a bit longer.
What's wrong, Valo?
Bolo has been kidnapped by that wretched cheese thief and his rats. I'm gonna follow them north and bring Bolo back.
We'll come with you, Valo.
We'll help rescue Bolo from Cheese Thief.
I can't ask you to do that, Scouts.
You saved our lives. This is all we can do to begin to repay you. Besides, we're heading north anyway, to the Otter's Den.
Yeah, and I can help.
No, Mila. You're staying here with Jeb.
But I'm strong and capable too, just like you are.
Mila.
If you don't let me help my brother, I'll just sneak out and do it myself. You know I've done it before. Don't leave me behind, Papa.
All right. We'll all go.
Good.
Brilliant. Then let's get moving.
Scout, what are you doing here? I told you to wait above.
You need help.
I can handle a few rats.
This is far more than a few. Besides, I think these stones here are our ticket to the den.
Of course they are. They'll cause a commotion and the rats will come flocking. I've already determined the solution, but I must save Bolo first.
Then let me be a diversion. I've been outwitting these vermin since Lilygrove. I'll buy you time.
Seeing as how you're already here, fine. You make a noise to the right while I sneak around to the left.
I heard someone just then.
Boy!
Bolo,
what are you doing?
I've got the stoat you wanted, Cheese Thief. I've kept my end of the bargain.
No, so you have. I should have given you more credit, stoat.
Why, Bolo? These rats are bandits and raiders.
Shut up. For years you've told me I had to live like those pathetic woodlanders. Well, not anymore. We're stoats and we belong here.
You don't know what you're saying.
I know enough.
Yes, this is all very touching. But do let me interrupt. Tell me, healer, where did your little mousey guests get off to?
What do you care?
They have something I want.
This can't be happening.
The plan had worked. Liam's guys had fooled the superstitious rat. But Valo...
Don't forget our healer, stoat, you hear me? He's coming with us.
No!
The exhausted and dejected friends were forced to continue onwards. What else could they do?
Helium! The Tangram! Will it work?
It's got to!
The scouts fit the key into the door, moving the pieces to and fro until it clicked into the door. Just as Valo had said, the ancient door swung open, and the scouts entered the Otter's Den.
What is this place?
All this has my stomach in a whirl.
Aye, let's take a moment.
You've got to eat, Mila. Don't worry, I'm sure Vala will be okay.
How do you know?
Well, I mean, Vala, your father, he's...
If I have learned anything about this world in this last 24 hours, it's that there is not a creature in existence who would go greater lengths for his family than Vala Scrimpor. I believe with my whole heart that he will be with you again soon. With your brother, too. Didn't you see the light in his eyes? It is as bright as the sun.
Sophia's right, Mila. They'll be okay. Once we get to Redwall, we can come back with help.
I've been wondering about that, actually. Can you tell me, what's Redwall like?
Redwall is a place of hope.
It helps and harbors anyone who needs it.
Redwallers can travel anywhere, through any territory, unharmed, because all beasts know they are good-willed and kind.
Those beasts are gentle, but strong too. Folks tend to forget that.
Ha! They weren't founded by a warrior for nothing.
How often do you visit Redwall?
Oh, we've never actually been. Not yet.
You haven't? But then, how do you know they'll let us in?
Redwall welcomes everyone, of course.
Not always. Them vermins are...
Glimber!
Mila, you are not vermin. You are from a family of healers, just like those at Redwall. You are a good stoat.
I'm sorry, Miss Mila. I'm a right fool of a mole, I am. I didn't mean you, of course. You be no vermin.
It's all right, Glimber. It's fine.
Mila.
We better get going, hadn't we?
Yes, I suppose so.
See you doesn't mean I can smell you. Where are you? Mousy, mousy, mousy. Where? You're mine now! You won't get away this time! To think you could escape, scum!
Oh!
wanted it, Liam. We never would have made it this far without you.
Oh, come now. We've still got to get you...
Mila?
Mila? What's wrong?
I can't. I'm not the best healer in the world yet.
You don't need to be the best to be welcome at Redwall. You can learn here. They'll protect you, help you.
We'll be with you, Mila.
No, I'm vermin, just like Bolo.
Why don't you say that, Mila? You know you're not.
They'll hear about what he did. They'll know. They'll say. I can't go yet. Not without Papa. Not without... I could be better. I'll be the best.
Oh, Mila, wait! It doesn't fit. There's a piece missing from this door. We were supposed to care for her.
So what are we supposed to do now?
I don't think there's anything we can do. She's gone.
And so she was.
Gone? Gone? But she can't have gone. Grandfather, that can't be the end.
Never fear, William. That is certainly not the end of young Mila's story.
I suppose Liam and the others didn't have much choice but to move forward. They had to get Sophia to Redwall.
Indeed.
How are you feeling, Sophia?
Don't worry about me. We've got to be almost there, don't you think?
Oh, I'd say more than almost, Miss Sophie.
Redwall, we finally made it.
Ahoy, travellers! You look like you've come a long way.
You could say that.
You're welcome here for whatever rest you need. Come!
Not all stories can end with a bow and cake, William. But that doesn't mean all is lost. It simply means there is more to come. And as for you, dear friend, while not every legend is known and not every tale is told, each is precious beyond measure. Your own tale may take you through pastures and perils, fields and fears. But should you ever find yourself wandering that woodland path, listen for the bells ringing in the distance. Smell the welcoming fires of the evening meal. Watch for that glimpse of red through the forest. Know that you are always welcome within our home, here at Redwall Abbey.